Hi, my name is Whitney, and today I want to show you how to make peppermint candy. So in Cinema 4D, what you're gonna do is start out with a cylinder. And basically we're just gonna try to make a like a candy shape, peppermint candy. So 100 for the radius. Let's see. 75 for the height. And then you want to go to caps. And with caps, you add a fillet so you get that rounded edge. And I think that looks nice. So, yeah, it looks good. Maybe it could be a little bit bigger. Okay, next you want to add a texture. And just put the texture right on the object, or you could slide it into the cylinder. Then click on the texture and go to color, and where it says color, you want a texture. So pick your candy texture and wait for it to load. Yay! And then you get candy on your texture. Instead, it looks all messed up. So, that's good. go to your UV button and press C to make your object editable. And this will allow you to mess around with your textures. So, click on your texture where it says projection, go to flat. And flat will literally have your texture be flat on a plane. And go to rotation, and then you can rotate it by holding shift, so it'll snap to 90 degrees. Close enough. If your object is too big like mine, then bring your length up, length U, and length V, and then you can just manually make it look a bit better. There you go. Yeah, looks good. Okay, so that doesn't really look like candy. It looks like a plastic wrapper of a candy. So we're gonna figure out how to make that look better. So go into your texture, and what you want to do is add a transparency. And that'll obviously make it invisible. You don't really want that. What we want to do is have it so the red part of the candy is more transparent and the white is more opaque. So here you upload your texture, and you see how the red is opaque but the white isn't. What we're going to do is switch that. So black point is going to be one. And then white point is going to be zero. And so that punches out the red. Next, you're gonna make the absorption color red, like a deep red candy. And refraction is very important because it gives it that thickness. When the light hits the object, it'll bend inside of it, kind of like glass. So absorption distance should be at 10 so that, it kind of captures all that redness. And you could add a blur in. I'm not sure how good it'll look, but it'll make it look a lot less perfect, which might be nice. Next, let's see. Let's see how that looks. Render it out. Here we go. And here we see how the red is transparent and the white is more opaque, like you would see on the candy. Those frosted edges. But yeah, it still doesn't look real. So what we can do is add reflection. which will make it tie into the environment a lot better. And for specular, you can make it a bit sharper by bumping up the height and bringing down the width. So it's a much more sharp glare. Yeah, okay. Looks pretty cool. So click here, and what we want to do is add a bump map so that it looks more imperfect. So we got a noise right here. And then, obviously that doesn't look good. So click inside noise. And what you're going to do is go to Booyah. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but it looks like Booyah. And that'll give it like that kind of chunky, air pockety, crystally look. Yeah. So what you get here is much more realistic. It might be a bit too much, so you could probably bring the bump down a bit. But that looks more like candy, I think. So yeah, you might want to tinker with the settings. Like, I'm not sure I like the blur. The bump map might be too much. You could bring it down or maybe up. I don't know. But yeah, just play with the settings. If you want to go further with this, you could put in a cloner to have multiple candies. And you could, like, stack them or put a random tag on it so they're, like, floating and falling in the air. Oh, I'm just gonna, I don't know, show it off. Put it in an environment. You could add a light. I always pick area light. You could put it in a sky. Give the sky a texture. It could be like an image or it could just be a color. Pink? Maybe pink. Yeah, I'm not sure how I feel about that. What you can do is go to render settings, and I always add global illumination. And inside those settings, you can bring the render down by putting 2, and then samples on low, record density on low, and what global illumination does is it adds brightness to the whole, I don't know, setting. So there's a lot less, like, harsh shadows and stuff. But it's not very good for doing animation, so be careful with it. If you like this tutorial and you want to see more from me, then like this video or do something to show that you want to see more. I might do one on modeling a Zelda temple or maybe some simple basics.